Hey, JP here. I'ma keep it short and simple with you guys, and today I'm going to teach you how to make a homemade protein powder for muscle growth. So the equipment that you are going to need in order to prepare it is going to be a scoop for measuring. I have an ice cream scoop, so I'm going to use that. A blender and two blending cups, one where you will store all your protein powder and one for the shake. Now for the ingredients, you are going to need chia seeds, quinoa seeds, flax seeds, pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds, hemp seeds, Brazil nuts, oats, and cocoa powder. Now that you have all the ingredients, it's time to make your homemade protein powder. So in a blender cup, you will need to add the following. 3 scoops of oats. Even though oats aren't considered a protein source, you know that it contains a lot of vitamins and minerals. Also, half a cup of dry oats contain a whopping 30 grams of protein and 8 grams of fiber, so it is a really good addition. 1 scoop of chia seeds. Given that by weight, chia seeds are 34% fat, 19% protein, and 45% carbohydrates, of which 83% is fiber, so they come in very handy. 1 scoop of flax seeds, for the simple reason that they consist of 42% fat, 29% carbs, and 18% protein. 1 scoop of quinoa seeds. Even though quinoa seeds are not considered a really big protein source, with just 4.4% of their weight being protein, it still has a lot of nutrients that your body needs in order to work properly, so it is really worthy to put it into our powder. 1 scoop of pumpkin seeds. Pumpkin seeds are a really good addition to our protein powder due to the fact that their weight is mainly from fat and protein. So 28 grams of pumpkin seeds are 7 grams of protein and 13 grams of fat, 6 of which are omega-6. 1 scoop of sunflower seeds. Apart from all their amazing nutrients, we are getting half of their weight in fats and 1/6 of their weight in protein. So it is something that really adds to the gain. 1 small scoop of hemp seeds. Now I know that hemp seeds are commonly more on the expensive side, but even then I would highly recommend to you to invest in them if you are vegan, because hemp seeds contain over 30% fat. They are exceptionally rich on omega-6 and omega-3. And hemp seeds are also a great protein source, as more than 25% of their total calories are from high quality protein. 1 scoop of Brazil nuts. Brazil nuts, apart from being extremely cheap in comparison to another nuts, are very nutritious and energy dense, with 1 ounce of Brazil nuts containing around 19 grams of fat and 4.1 grams of protein. And finally, 1 scoop of cocoa powder. Cocoa powder has a lot of health benefits attached to it, but we are going to put it for the simple reason that it adds an amazing flavor to our protein. Now it's time to blend it, and my suggestion is that you blend it for just 3 seconds, because if you blend it for more time, it is going to get a pretty pasty texture. So 3 seconds is going to be okay. And that's it. Now you have an amazing homemade protein powder. Now, what are we going to use that protein powder for? That's right, we are going to use it to make protein shakes. So I'm going to show to you how to make a really amazing protein shake with our protein powder. So grab another blender cup and add 1 or 2 scoops of your protein powder. 1 scoop for me is okay, however if you want to add 2 scoops, that's completely fine. After that, add 1 frozen banana for 2 simple reasons. 1, it is very nutritious, and 2, it gets a really good flavor in our protein shake. Now it's time to put on the water. I like to put one cup of water because I think that that is the perfect balance between watery and pasty. However, it depends on how watery you want it to be, but my recommendation still is going to be one cup of water. Now, since I am vegetarian, I like to add 2 spoons of Greek yogurt to it. However, vegans could add almond milk, I don't know how to pronounce it quickly, almond milk instead. So now it's time to organize everything that we have used and put another banana into the freezer. Blend what you have for 30 or 40 seconds and there you go. Now you have a delicious and nutritious protein shake with our homemade protein powder. I encourage you to prepare it and tell me if you liked it in the comment section. The next upload is going to be something really special, so if you don't want to miss it out, don't forget to subscribe in order to stay tuned. Stay growing, that's all from me, see you in the next one.